It's so many memories with Dirk McGirt. You know what I mean? A lot of minds is like, you know, because he was just like, you know, he loved women. You know what I mean? So, you know, he just loved to go in. One of them joints, I think he might have been burning or something. You know what I mean? You know, he had friction burns on his dick, and I seen the nigga, he loved pussy so much, I seen the nigga wrap gauze around his dick. You know what I mean? Just to get some pussy, he then put the condom over the gauze, so his dick was looking like that fat. You know what I mean? Still fucked the bitch. he still fucked this shit. So it's like, yo, but I guess when you got a friction burn and you get some pussy, it make it feel better though. But I guess that's if you're going raw though. But this nigga loved it so much, it was like he just kept fucking. You know what I mean? So I got mad moments with him though, but that's just one of the littlest ones though. Then that's my dude right there. He's off the meat. Me and Ray's from two different projects. We like 5 minutes from each other, you know what I mean? I'm from Stapleton Projects, he's from Park Hill Projects. You know what I'm saying? But a lot of us went to school with each other. That's how we got to know, you know what I mean? Got to know each other and stuff like that. But my project was a fighting project. We liked to fight a lot, you know what I mean? Back in the 80s, his project, you know, they used to get fly project. You know what I mean? But we used to go up there because they had the weed spot. We had the mescaline in the dust spots down where we at, you know what I mean? So everybody used to like go to, you know, when we needed some weed, we walk to the hill. You know what I mean? You know what I mean? They used to be coming down there, you know, getting the mescaline and the dust, whatever, take it back up to their neighborhood though. But they was some fly motherfuckers and shit, but what they, you know, like he was, you know, they would rhyme, you know what I mean? Be in the staircase rhyming and, you know what I mean? It was kind of fun up there, you know what I mean? So down in my projects, we was doing the same thing. We was rhyming and all that other shit, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, before you know it, you know, we started getting together, you know what I mean? RZA used to come, RZA moved down to my projects. And it was just something about RZA, you know what I mean? Like, I knew that one day, he had an aura about him where he had a lot of people around him, you know what I mean? He brought all that fly shit, like, to the hill, like that get fly shit, you know what I mean? That Polo, Tommy Hill, Pacific Trail shit. You know what I mean? So it was like, before, you know, when the younger stages, it was on some more like out as you shit. You know, everybody was poor. You know what I mean? You know, just not, you know, not saying poor like living on the streets, but you know, you gotta, you know, your mom's a single parent and she got a bunch of kids and she got her little man, whatever. Then that man get kicked out. Then, you know, she get a little other friend, you know what I mean? And shit like that, though, and really not having that. But, hey, you know, a lot of people go through that. But I'm just talking like 16 and up now, you know what I mean? And like, you're right, you know, you start smoking wools, you know, you selling cracks, you start smoking wools, you know what I mean? Dust and weed and all the other shit. And, you know, like I said, I met RZA, one thing led to another, you know, a nigga like me start getting that money, you was getting that money out there, out of town, out of state, whatever, and came back and called the fellas, called the rest of the crew up, and, you know, we just popped off. But he walked that dog, though. So going from that to where I am right now, it's like, it's a blessing because it was like, yo, I'm the oldest in my family. So it's like being right there, I was like a diamond in the rough. You know what I mean? I would have never thought, because I've been through so much shit. You know what I mean? Getting stabbed and other places trying to get money, getting shot, trying to get money, went to jail a few times, you know what I mean? Did a little skid bid at like 15 years old, you know what I mean? For robbing, you know what I mean? And shit like that. So it's like to go from that to where we at right now, yo, it's like, yo, you be a fool to do some dumb shit, you know what I mean? And shit like that. It's like, yo, I would never knew that I would land in you know, places like Japan and Australia and all that other shit when I was that nigga. Well, you could never tell me I was going to be there one day. Could never told me that. You know what I mean? But one thing I did know, I knew when I was, because I started rhyming like around like, maybe like 15 or something like that, 14 or whatever. Started taking it serious as the years went on. But when I got to like 87, I seen it. I seen where I was at. I must have dreamt it. I seen it. It was so clear to me that I knew that I was going to be that nigga one day. You know what I mean? And years, you know, took a while. You know what I mean? And then shit just popped off. You know what I mean? So I knew where I was going. I felt it. I knew it. It just came to me. I don't know how or what the fuck it just came. But to go from that to where we at right now, yo, man, all praises is due to the Most High. You know, because all this is just blessings, yo. And that's it. And my best friends is doing co-defendants. You know what I mean? I was like, nah, chill. You know what I mean? You just do what you got to, whatever. It's doing 25 years and, you know what I mean, to life and all types of shit. I was around that crowd like that, though. You know what I mean? So, and that's just what it is. I dreamt about being on stage. I seen myself on stage. Can't tell y'all I was looking, whatever. But I dreamt of it. I don't know. I just felt it. Now, don't get me wrong. As them years go by and you pass those years up and nothing is happening, all right, it seemed like, you know, like it seemed like it could leave you. You know what I mean? But I seen it. You know what I mean? So when it did came on, it was when all this came about, it was like, okay, there it is. You know what I'm saying? So I seen myself, yo, and that was it. And that was the plaques and all that, you know what I mean? You know, we did Can It Be All So Simple, you know what I mean? My first Jewelry in the Wind goal, we seen that, you know what I mean? Raven seen it around that time, I mean, of that time right there, because he was like, yo, before we did the Wu album, he said, yo, I had a dream, yo, we was chilling, B, we had mad plaques and all this other stuff like that, you know what I mean? And we knew we was going to be the illest when we came in. We already knew that. You know what I mean? I mean, hands down, it was no competition. No competition. Especially back then.